In this episode, we take you with us on our repairing tour in the hot and steamy surroundings of Suriname. Suriname is also known as Dutch Guiana. It is situated in the northeast of South Africa, just between French and British Guiana, just a little above Brazil. As you might remember from the last episode, we have some fixing to do, because the chain plates of Bolla cracked during our Atlantic crossing. But before we start fixing, what's the problem anyway? This is Bolla in the slings at shipyard St. Malo in France. You might want to watch Bolla Brig 2 for more French slinging. And now the situation. This is how a 3-year-old would draw the hull of Bolla. And the mast. And the rigging. Now it gets interesting. Because in red you see the chain plates we need to fix and upgrade. Let's watch a little closer to see how the chain plates are attached to the hull. Luckily it's heavy manufactured, but the forces aren't passed on to the hull very efficient. We can do better than that. We engineered a new construction with correct angles and a large holding surface that most certainly will not break again. And we will do it in the 1956 style, with rivets, just like modern airplanes use nowadays. For all that fixing and do-it-yourself stuff, we need materials, aluminum and turnbuckles. Aluminum shouldn't be that hard to find around here, at least we think. Suriname is known for its bauxite mines in the past, and bauxite is the main ingredient for aluminum. So we go alu hunting and take a look at different turnbuckles. The turnbuckles weren't that hard to find, but the aluminum was. So after a few shops, Mark started calling. And calling. No luck. No thick aluminum in Suriname. We tried every company and their suppliers, but no luck at all. A little frustrated, we take a day off and go for a road trip to the Brokopondo Lake, a man-made lake. Here the flooded woods are still a silent reminder of the forced movement of the villages in the days the lake was constructed. The man-made lake was used for the energy for the production of aluminum. How ironic! The fixing job is still in the back of our mind, and on our way home we pass sewage scrap. A scrapyard. So maybe?
En leer.
Oeh.
Klaar in de midden, goed profielen.
Dik genoeg ook? 5 mm of nee?
Ja, dit is wel vaar, dit helpt wel.
Is hij niet helemaal verbogen en zo?
Nee. Dan pak deze, er liggen nog meer. Het enige wat we niet hebben is een stuk ertussen. Maar ook dat. Ik weet nu wat ik vandaan haal. Deze moet je even.
Pinnetje?
Pinnen. Deze hebben we gepikt. Er
een dikke
klink.
Dus je hebt echt heel weinig nodig.
Hoe ziet de andere kant er nu uit?
Ja, mooi.
Ja, it looks nice. Wat is de bedoeling? Gaan we eens kijken of dit lukt.
We shaped the material for both sides of the boat, just somewhere on an industrial plot in Suriname. Now it's time to attach the new construction to the hull, also with rivets. First we put holes and after that screws. Then one by one replace the screws with rivets. Oh, Melinda slays with a hammer on the outside and Mark absorbs the forces in the inside.
Ga er weer vandoor.
Echt nog?
Is het klaar?
Nee, het is nog lang niet klaar, maar ik kan wel weer hier.
Nou, doei!
Oké. Ik zie zo niks van of je het dek naar beneden krijgt, hoor.
And almost finished, at least the part we can fix in Suriname. The cracks on deck need to be welded by an aluminum expert. No way we can find good one here in Suriname. We're happy with the result, and now it's time to celebrate the skipper his birthday.
Is er een jarig, hoera, hoera, en dat kun je wel zien, dat is hij. Nee.
Nassie van opa.
Het is heel donker.
Ik wil nog
niet weg. Nee, 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 nee.
Want to know why I'm screaming this loud? You'll see that in the next episode about our Suriname adventures.